today is the 16th of April. It's about 8:30 in the morning. And I'm on my way to a town that's about 25 miles from where we live. I'm heading to Morrilton, Arkansas. Morrilton, it's in Conway County. And the reason I'm heading that way is we're going to the ham radio club up here is going to be testing some individuals for ham radio licenses. I guess some of them are upgrades from tech to general class. And the fellow that's in charge of all that, his name is James Taylor. He requested that if there were any volunteer examiners that would be willing to help out, he'd appreciate it. And they need those with extra class licenses and, of course, the VE certificate, which is volunteer examiner. So I told him, sure, I'll come up, you know. You know, even though it's an overcast and rainy morning, this is my favorite time of year, or one of my favorite times of year. I like the fall also in Arkansas. All the trees have budded out. Everything is green for the first time since winter. Just gorgeous. I really like it. We're just now entering the outskirts of Morrilton. This is the newer side of town. You know, we'll be going down in the old part of town, the what I consider to be the historical part of town. There's where our subways are, Taco Bells and all that jazz. Over here's a Waffle House. I've eaten many a steak and eggs in that place, I'll tell you. I always like Waffle House steak and eggs. Well, unfortunately, they're not always, you know, the same as far as quality. But we'll shut it off, and when we get down the main part of the old town, I'll fire the camera back up. All right, here's the older part of town that was here, that's been here for hundreds of years, at least 100 years. And you can see the old tall brick buildings in the distance. Over here on the left a little ways is the old railroad depot. And I think it's maintained now by the Historical Society of Conway County. They had the old movie theaters on the right. As we go by, you'll see it as soon as the old red light decides to change here. I like Morrilton. I think it's a quaint little town. I've always liked it. Some folks don't agree with me, but yeah, I'm not really interested in what some folks agree or don't agree with me. All the old brick buildings here from years ago. They had one that collapsed here not too long ago. There's the old movie theater, the Rialto. And then over here is your old railroad depot. Right there. The Historical Society, Genealogy Society. They hold their meetings in the old Morrilton Depot. This used to be a big cotton town at one time. Boy, I'll tell you what, there'd be millions of bales of cotton. Now, I need to take a right here on Division Street, which is right here. And then we're going to go to the post office. I have never been to the post office. This ought to be interesting. Well, there it is right there. Well, there's the old post office. We'll be holding the ham radio licensing in the bottom. So I need to get my buns down there. I'm starting to get close to the witching hour here. Now, according to James, the fellow that's running the show, he says all you got to do is go down the alley. Well, let's go down the alley. I've never been here. This ought to be interesting. I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and park right in here. I think I can park there. It says employee only. But since nobody works here anymore, I guess I can go ahead and park here. By the way, this building is also utilized now by the Emergency Services, Department of Emergency Services for Conway County. So let's go ahead. We got to go down in the steps down there and go in that door. Everybody say hi to James Taylor. Yeah, you're the old singer, right? You used to be a singer. Yeah, right? He was a rock star in front of the microphone. You may not recognize him.
Years ago.
Yeah, he's got a lot more hair now.
Yeah.
Anyway, what is your position here at the emergency services?
I am the communications officer.
He's the communications officer. Look at this. Look at this. Looks like the star. I was telling him it looks like Starship Enterprise here. He's got the captain's chair there. All he needs is a few electronic buttons. He puts the fake buttons there, you know, that you just press and they light up and all that, you know. So we're going to be testing at probably four for extra class license, and maybe one for tech. Maybe nobody will show up. You never know,
well,
do you? You know
that's true. But I'm those four that have said they'll be here for their extra.
Mm-hmm.
They're all local. And they've all pretty well assured me that they'll be here before 9:30.
Okay, well, good. Now, this is Bill, and you are KE5SUE. I'm KF5GMC. By the way, I haven't met you, Bill. And he's going to be one of the volunteer examiners like me to help out and get these guys through the tests, right?
Right.
Now, you didn't bring any cheat sheets or anything like that, did you?
No.
No, okay. You left them at the house, did you? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we have three brand new extra class ham radio license holders. Congratulations to all three of you. What's your first name and call sign?
Eric. Call sign is KF5WHN.
Congratulations. One more time, my friend. And?
Roger, KF5SDE.
Congratulations again. And last one?
I'm Jeremy, N5JKL/AE, right?
He couldn't be a KF5. He had to be different. Congratulations. New guys, new extra class. That should fire some of my video observers up. And ladies and gentlemen, we have the former mayor of Morrilton here, Mayor Stuart Nelson, and he is KD5LBE. He is the test proctor for today. I guess they call you a proctor, right?
That's okay.
I don't know the official name.
Not much pay for it.
Not much pay, huh? I just want you to know that I rub elbows with the big boys when I come down to Morrilton. Well, the testing session is over. And that's the first time I've ever been in a testing session where everybody passed the extra class. That was pretty cool. Well, right now I'm heading back to the house, and from there we have a second place to go to today. Let me see, what time is it? It's about 10:50 in the morning. Our next stop is at a two-cylinder antique tractor show, which is about a mile from the house. And I'm gonna see if I can't get somebody to talk to me about this stuff. But, you know, here's one from 1939. Obviously not John Deere colors, but it's in, I guess it's in memory of cancer awareness. In the last segment of my video, I was talking to the ex-mayor of Morrilton, and now I'm talking to the president of...
The Central Arkansas Two-Cylinder Club.
The Central Arkansas Two-Cylinder Club.
Right.
And is it strictly John Deere?
No. So, we are an antique tractor club.
And where there has to be some home for it all. Where's that located?
Well, we have our meetings. We have our shows here at Pickles Gap, and we have our meetings at the Fish House in Conway.
How convenient, at the Fish House.
We
and what is your first name?
My name is Howard.
Howard, and who's this young fella over here? This Vietnam vet.
Customers. This is Russell King.
A customer.
I buy and sell tractor parts.
Oh, you do?
I buy and sell tractor parts. Oh. My tractors and the whole works.
And where are you from?
I'm from Jacksonville.
Jacksonville. We lived over there a few years.
I've been into this since 1989.
You like it, apparently, huh?
And I've been on the farm. I'll be 65 in November, and I've been running one of these ever since I was 5 years old.
Okay, I was going to ask you that. You know, tell the truth. You have probably had a couple of hours in the seats of one of these tractors at one time in your life?
A couple of hours at time or two. And I got a 60-acre farm now. I've been working for Mac George Contracting Company for 42 years, and I got a 60-acre farm I'm going to when I retire.
Where's that at?
Watson, Arkansas.
In Arkansas, Watson, Arkansas. What county is that located?
Deschutes County.
Deschutes County.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's cool. All right, so how many members do you have? Yeah, I want you to tell my viewers something we don't know. How many members do you have?
We send out 85 newsletters each month. Mm-hmm. We've probably got active members probably 70.
All right, let's go down and take a look at these. This is really kind of neat, you know. I mean, I know nothing at all about this stuff, zero, except that they plow dirt.
I just saw it.
Here's another one. This thing, look at here. Ooh, boy, check that out. Power steering. Now, I know that somebody out there who watches this channel has an interest in this sort of thing, or at least you used to. Or you had a grandpa that used to have one of these or something. You know, there's going to be somebody who will connect. 1959. Man, this tire is even higher. God, it's up to about my chin. Here's one from 1951. also owned by Ken Johnson. I guess they bring all these trailers down and all these tractors down, those trailers over there. Boy, they got some money wrapped up in this, I'll tell you. Here's a 1946, owned by Ken Johnson. 1946. I like that year, good year. Here's a Ford right here. Saw a lot of Fords when I was a kid, Ford tractors. Didn't see too many John Deere. Most of the stuff I saw was the Ford. Here we have an International Harvester. I don't know what year it is. Maybe it'll say something on the name tag about that, or on the... looks like maybe a 1945, maybe? I don't know. It's got a number there, serial number. Part of the serial number might be the year, I don't know. Wouldn't be 1815, that's for sure. Made in America, folks. McCormick Farmall, International Harvester again. This looks rather new here. Let's see what year this is. 1949. Here's a 1936. Who is Chris Kelly and Elizabeth Jones?
Well, this is two of us right here.
That's 2 years right there. Well, who owns all this stuff?
I really do.
You really do? You like tractors? Well, they're certainly not iPhones, are they? You drive those things?
Every now and then.
Every now and then? Have you ever plowed fields 12 hours a day? Plow through the night with the headlights on?
I've not done that.
Your training has been really bad.
I would do it if you let me.
Planted wheat. How about that? Grilled wheat.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Well, let her do it. They're putting women in combat now, for crying out loud. She can get out here and plow a little dirt, can't you?
Yeah.
You bet. How many of these do you own? You own one, two?
Got two,
just got two right here? Well, just got two. How many do you own?
About seven.
Seven? Where do you store these? Like in a big barn or something?
I've just got a shop.
Wow. Have you ever, do you just like restore these? I mean, you've never plowed any dirt with them or anything like that, have you? They're just for show and the fun, just for fun. Well, that's cool. Here's a couple of oldies, an old Ford, another old Ford. This is my kind of stuff, you know. This looks like, this has to be like something from the 50s or 60s. Just gotta be, just the way the shape of that thing. I don't know what year it would be, of course. And this looks like something out of the 40s. You are the man. What's your first name, sir?
Tim.
Tim, you are the man who owns this McCormick Deering. What year is this thing?
1928.
1928. Holy mackerel. Where'd you pick that up with?
Harlan Iowa.
And how long have you owned it?
About 3 weeks.
Oh, really? So you went all the way to Iowa and picked it up? What are your plans to do with this?
Restore it.
You're going to restore it. Have you ever done one before?
Not one of those. I've done some John Deeres and some Fords. Alice Chalmers.
Are you from the area here?
Heber Springs.
Heber Springs. Oh, you're down here a few miles away then.
Well, I'm born and raised here in Conway.
Yeah, but I'm talking about as far as you're living, you live up in Heber Springs.
Yeah.
That's a nice country up there, Heber Springs. That's great. Well, this is pretty darn neat. Does it even start and run?
I have not started it yet. I'm trying to get it to the point it's ready to start.
Well, how did you even find out about it?
It was on a Facebook tractor group.
No kidding. Yeah. Some guy said it's for sale. And you said, no, not any longer, right?
Yeah, do it.
Well, that's great. 1928 McCormick Deering. Where was this thing made?
I think in Chicago.
Chicago.
It's a subsidiary of IHC.
Oh, it's a subsidiary of International Harvest. How about that? God, I can't even imagine sitting in that seat all day.
Well, if I'm up here and give it a shot.
No. No thanks. I'm on my way to the another thing going on up the road here. That's really slick. That is really slick. Well, how long do you think it'll take for you to restore it? Is it about 4 or 5 years?
About a year.
About a year, really? It takes a long time sometimes.
Well, this is actually in pretty good shape.
Are there parts available for this sort of thing?
There's sometimes you got to fabricate your own, and you can buy most of the parts.
No kidding. I guess they're all repro, right?
Yeah. I'll keep original.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So what I'll do is, like, on these fenders here with the track, flip, somebody patched them.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll take and grind that out, re-weld it, and smooth it out.
Yeah, typical body work type stuff.
Straighten all this out.
How thick is that, by the way?
Boy, I hadn't put a caliper on there, but it's pretty solid stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty solid stuff from 1928. That's amazing. Well, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And good luck with it, okay? All right. One last thing with Tim. I asked him, he's retired now, and he works on this as a hobby, and he owns this Alice Chalmers right here that he brought down. And I said, are these the only two tractors that you own? And what was your response?
I own about 13.
He owns 13? Holy mackerel. You know, it's like some of the old antique radio collectors, you know, they have like a gazillion of these things, you know. That was pretty cool. Well, I'm glad you're having fun at it. I really am. Thanks. Yeah. Well, I really enjoyed the old tractor show. That was fun. Okay, we have the next stop coming up. Hopefully they'll have something to eat when I get there. I haven't eaten all day and I'm starving. Our last stop of the day is at a place called Woolly Hollow State Park. It's about 15, 16 miles from the house. And today they're having a mountain man rendezvous. And this is all the tents. I think this is the first rendezvous of the year. There'll be maybe one or two more in Arkansas. But we're gonna go talk to a few folks. I love mountain man rendezvous. Here's a shot from right in the center of all the tents. I think that guy down there with the white beard, we're gonna see if I can zoom in on his little butt. I think I know that man right there. He's right there in the checkered shirt. Let me go see the other side of that tree. Let me see if I can find him. Here we have Larry and Mary. I like that, you know? Yeah. And for those of you who watch my videos, in 2009 was the last time I saw them. And I filmed him at another rendezvous. And you're still going strong at it, aren't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, he was the one dressed in red and with the three-cornered black hat. I'll never forget. He's the one that showed me the buffalo screwed him.
Yeah.
I'll never forget that. And there's Mary. She's looking sweet as ever. You're still, yeah. Are you dragging him around or is he dragging you around? Or do you drag each other?
Yeah, we drag each other, huh?
You're still having fun at it, all right? When's the next rendezvous within maybe the Little Rock area again? Around July or August or
May.
May.
Outside of Bryant, Saline County rendezvous.
Okay.
They call it the Saline Crossing.
Now you gonna be there?
We're hoping to be.
Okay.
I didn't make the last two at Saline. I did the first one.
Uh-huh.
They were still holding it on the old airport runway.
Mm-hmm.
But this one, they've got a park down there at the old bridge.
Well, I'll tell you what. It's not as many as was here when I saw you down at that mountain. What was the name of that place?
Pinnacle Mountain.
Yeah, that was good. Are they going to have that again this year? No.
They quit that about 4 years
ago. Really? Yep. Oh, that's a shame. There was a lot of people there.
A lot of people.
Oh, that's amazing.
The last two or three years, it was 100 camps or better.
Yeah, 100 camps, yeah.
And wow. The rest of them we do, we'll have 20 to.
Well, why'd they end it? Any idea?
The support group, Partners for Pinnacle, they just decided they didn't want to do
it. That's terrible. You know, you get something going good, and there's always somebody got to ruin it, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, well. Check out these knives. Now, that knife might look a little small to you, but I guarantee you it's not. I couldn't even carry it. Oh, Larry said that it was Mary's neck knife. Holy mackerel, look at that thing. Bone handle and everything. I couldn't even carry that for very long. I'd be tired. There's supposed to be a rendezvous going on around here somewhere. You all know where that's at?
You have no idea.
You have no idea. Are you folks from this area here? Where are you all from?
I'm from Benton.
Little Rock. Well, that's down. Benton's just south of.
I'm from Texarkana.
What are you doing way up here?
Didn't I run around with these people all the time.
All the time, huh? And where are you from?
I'm from Carlisle.
Carlisle. Well, I'll tell you what, we got representation all over the state. Is that some of those Mountain Man cigarettes there, too? Are they the Roll Yones? I bet he. Did you grow that tobacco for him, did you?
No.
No.
He grows
all
of
it. Look at down here. I'm looking at the best dressed people here. What are y'all? Oh my goodness, you all got it all going here, don't you? Wash pots.
You either love this or you hate it, but
I think it's cool myself. I mean, I could never get into it, but I like being here and watching it, and looking at it, you know.
KB5 UWC.
I'm sorry.
KB5 UWC.
KF5 GMC. Great Megacycles. That's me. What you doing that for? My curiosity is driving me crazy.
I'm gonna bake a cake.
You're gonna put it like in a Dutch oven or something?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, okay, that's cool.
Yeah,
just lay it on a metal plate. That's a good idea. Yeah. Just lay it out there.
I didn't want to burn anything up here. But one of my adopted sons is sitting right over there, and it's his birthday today.
Well, happy birthday. I'm gonna have to go over there and say happy birthday. And how old is he?
He'll be 20.
20 years old.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you. Yeah, wouldn't it be nice to be 20 again? Oh, I don't know. In today's world, I'm not so certain, you know. We like it the way it is.
I liked it better when I was 20.
Yeah. Let me go see him. What's his name? Who's Matthew?
That's me.
Well, I understand today's your birthday, huh?
It is. Yeah.
Well, happy birthday. Your adopted mom told you over there. Yeah. Well, that's good. Look, check that. You're married?
Sir?
Are you married?
No, sir.
You see, hey, ladies, watch my videos on YouTube. This guy's single. His name is Matthew.
I'm not single, but I'm not married.
Oh, you're not single, but look, if you're not married, you're single, okay? Simple. I knew a guy one time. I asked him, I said, you ever been married? He said, no, but I've been divorced 3 times. Well, congratulations. 20 years old, huh?
Yes, sir.
Good man. All right. How long have you been doing this stuff?
7 years.
Good. You like it?
I love it.
It's kind of relaxing to get out and do something different.
Yeah.
Something totally different from what all the other chumps are doing, you know?
Right. I started the black powder shooting stuff when I was a little kid with my grandpa, and then I guess about 7 years ago. So
that's great.
I really got started then.
That's great. I'm glad to see it. And we have another bunch over here. I'm looking for the best looking one here. I think I found her. How you doing?
Right.
What we got here? What's all that stuff?
Some crackers I made. Back in the day, this would have been hardtack.
Is that what they call hardtack?
Basically, they were really hard crackers, but
not after this morning.
Make them, and they would
my grandfather's house is
poke holes in them, and they cook them, and they're about yay thick, and they're just as hard. You can't even break them.
Yeah.
But this is our modern day.
Looks like a cracker.
It is. They had 9 holes in them.
What do you put on them?
Well, I've got some jalapeno pepper.
No, I'm talking about what's all that seasoning. Out. What's that seasoning you got
this
on?
This one has Curly Bob barbecue. Because this is flavored and cumin and flaxseed.
Can I try one?
Sure.
Yeah,
you're
never,
not allergic.
Nah.
Sue me if you swell up.
I'm not allergic to anything.
You get sick and get the runs. I'm a nurse and
I'm allergic to work too. And what's your name?
My name is, they call me No-Nose.
No-Nose. No-Nose or No-Nose?
No-Nose.
No-Nose.
They tell me No-No a lot. They call me No-Nose. No.
Well, that's pretty good. I never thought about that.
This one has cilantro, parsley, lime oil, and some lemon powder.
What is your first name?
Teresa.
And I'm eating some crackers that she made. She put seasoning on, oil, and different kinds of seed. Boy, this stuff is good. I'm going to get me a box of crackers when I go home and try it myself. I like trying all kinds of new stuff, you know. Boy, that's good.
If you get on the internet, you can find firecrackers, and that's the basic recipe.
What's it called?
Firecrackers,
all right.
That's a good place to start because it's got the recipe, and you use a package of Bell and Ranch dressing.
Now, this is YouTube you're talking about, right? Or just non-YouTube? Well, you're going to be on YouTube. That's what this is all about, see? I have many, many, many YouTube videos up, and I do. This is my second rendezvous to be putting folks up. That's very nice to meet you, Teresa.
Nice to meet you.
Boy, that's some good stuff.
It is good stuff.
Man, I like it. Now, this is a big tent here. Let me ask you something. Is there any significance to this large tent, or you just have a bunch of folks here?
Sir?
What's the significance to the larger tent?
A lot of these would use the front piece as a store.
Mm-hmm.
And the back piece would be the bedroom.
Oh, okay. So you're demonstrating that, you're showing that. Is that what this is all about? Okay, front piece is a store. The back piece is where you sleep and cook.
And kind of a small living quarter.
Well, I can't leave yet. What are you doing here?
Okay, I'm putting the seats in these chairs.
So where do you get, where,
You buy seats with bad, you buy chairs with bad seats or something?
Yeah, they belonged to a friend of mine, and he just wanted to get rid of them.
Mm-hmm.
And the seats were all blown out of them, messed up. So I really like this pattern.
Yeah.
And
so where'd you learn how to do that?
Believe it or not, I just read a book on it.
That's great. I love that. You know, that's if everybody would do that, we'd be a lot smarter nation, you know, but no one wants to read a book anymore. If it's not on an iPhone, they don't want anything to do with it, you know? Yep. Well, thanks again.
You bet you, sir.
Well, that was fun. My battery's about dead in my camera, so I'm going to go ahead and call an end to it. I hope you all enjoyed that. This is a long video, I know, but you know, everybody says, don't worry about putting up long videos, John. We like them. I said, okay, fine. Here's a test. You know, put your money where your mouth is, guys, as they say. This is good stuff. This is really a lot of fun. This is the kind of thing I enjoy going to. I couldn't participate in it. It'd be too much work for me. But I sure like visiting these people. These are good folk, let me tell you. Good folk. Until next time, this is John. Incidentally, this is what the lake looks like at Woolly Hollow State Park. On the other side of that thing sticking out around the corner, there's a swimming area. Wifey and I used to bring the grandkids here a lot when they were small, and we still come here from time to time in the summertime. It's great. It's a wonderful place. You can go fishing. They have some paddle boats you can rent. They have a little place to eat down the road here, a little ways, which would be around the corner where the swimming area is. They have it all, you know, roped off. Wonderful little place. A lot of people come here. It's quiet. At 10 o'clock at night, everything is supposed to go quiet. And if it's not quiet, they boot you out. Great spot.